A New Zealander locked up in a Bali prison where COVID-19 is rampant is sick and says he'll die if not helped. Anthony de Malmanche was arrested in Bali 6 years ago, caught with drugs in his suitcase. He maintains his innocence, saying he was a pawn in an elaborate online scam. Sam Kelway with this exclusive report.
Anthony de Malmanche arrested in Bali after being caught with nearly 2 kilograms of meth in his backpack. It's been 6 years since the 58-year-old was found guilty of drug trafficking. 6 years of insisting he's innocent.
He's there for the wrong reasons in the first place.
His family and legal team say he was scammed by a highly organised cartel.
I don't think he should be convicted to death for essentially being gullible on the internet.
Since then, Anthony's health has rapidly deteriorated. He has chronic obstructive pulmonary disorder and says he's slowly drowning as fluid floods his lungs.
On and off, usually gets pretty sick, cold, achy. Yeah, he's had issues with his heart as well. He's got diagnosed with angina.
The prison is well over capacity.
He's got, as far as I understand it, another three or four people in the cell. It's essentially a broom closet.
Although small, his cell is paid for by family.
If you don't pay, you don't get a room, you don't get a bunk. You just have to pretty much fend for yourself.
COVID-19 is now rife in the prison and de Malmanche has asked to be released on health grounds. In October, he wrote to the Prime Minister, saying he's at very high risk of death, describing the prison as overcrowded with no chance of isolation. In a statement, the Prime Minister's office says it received the letter and the request falls within the responsibilities of the Foreign Affairs Minister. But Minister Mahuta says she can't comment for privacy reasons.
I just want the government to try and work together with the Indonesian government to get him home.
A simple plea from a family desperate for help.
He's got grandkids here and kids here that just miss him and don't want to lose him.
Sam Kelway, One News.